Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. On September 28th, NASA's Orion spacecraft was moved from Kennedy Space Center's Payload Hazardous Servicing Facility to its Launch Abort System Facility for installation of its Launch Abort System, one of the many critical safety systems that will be evaluated during Orion's uncrewed Exploration Flight Test 1 in December. NASA's new deep space capsule is being developed to safely transport astronauts to and from Mars and other destinations on future missions. At Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, the United Launch Alliance Delta IV Heavy, the rocket that will launch Orion into space on its targeted December 4th flight test, was moved from the Horizontal Integration Facility to the launch pad at Space Launch Complex 37. Following the move, members of the media were invited to watch as the Delta IV was raised to the vertical position. Orion also is scheduled to be moved to the pad in mid-November, where it will be hoisted atop the Delta IV rocket. A press briefing on October 3rd at Johnson Space Center previewed two scheduled U.S. spacewalks outside the International Space Station. The goals of the October 7th spacewalk by NASA's Reid Wiseman and Alexander Gerst of the European Space Agency include installation of backup power for the station's mobile transporter, while the October 15th spacewalk by Wiseman and fellow NASA astronaut Barry Wilmore is designed to replace a voltage regulator for the station's power system. While attending the International Astronautical Congress in Toronto, Canada on September 30th, NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden and Indian Space Research Organization Chairman K. Radhakrishnan signed agreements to discuss future joint exploration of Mars and a joint satellite to observe Earth's changing ice cover, ecosystem, and solid surface. A helicopter crash test at Langley Research Center on October 1st was the second in a year for a project being conducted by NASA and other U.S. and international government agencies. The Transport Rotorcraft Airframe Crash Testbed Full-Scale Crash Test involved dropping a helicopter fuselage from a height of 30 feet. Data and imagery recorded during the test will be used to help develop safer, more efficient helicopters. Administrator Bolden recently helped kick off the 2014 combined federal campaign of the National Capital Area during an event at the agency's headquarters in Washington. Each year, donations from NASA employees make a positive impact on the lives of others who are less fortunate. This year, there are more than 25,000 approved local, national, and international charities to which employees around the agency can donate. The campaign ends December 15th. In recognition of National Cybersecurity Awareness Month, which began October 1st, NASA's Associate Administrator Robert Lightfoot participated in a kickoff event at NASA headquarters to stress for employees the importance of online security in protecting NASA and personal assets. Agency workers are encouraged to stop and think before they connect and go online. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.